Friends, welcome once again in our digital communication course, where we are going to discuss digital continuous wave modulation techniques. In last video lecture, we have discussed the waveform comparison between binary ASK, FSK and PSK. On the basis of classification, digital continuous wave modulation techniques are amplitude shift keying, that is ASK, frequency shift keying, FSK, and phase shift keying, that is PSK. PSK is further modified or updated as quadrature PSK. And the combining effect of ASK and PSK is called quadrature amplitude modulation, that is QAM. This QAM scheme is suitable where a high bit rate is required in order to minimize the bit error in the receiving data. So here we note a point. In all continuous wave digital modulation techniques, modem is used as a device for modulation-demodulation process. And one of the questions arises in our mind that why we can't send digital signal over telephone lines, or why should we modulate digital signal before transmission over these telephone lines? This is because digital data is the binary waves of zeros and ones, and there is an abrupt change in levels from high to low or from low to high. This change in level requires a large bandwidth in order to transmit without any distortion. But with using telephone lines, this requirement is not fulfilled, as the bandwidth of telephone lines is very small. Hence, there is a need of modulation process in which a high frequency sinusoidal carrier wave is used. And only after the modulation process, low bandwidth telephone lines can be used for high speed data transmission. So we can say that using modulation or high frequency carrier wave, the bandwidth requirement get reduced, and this is an advantage of using continuous wave digital transmission techniques. So the basic and fundamental digital continuous wave modulation technique is ASK modulation, that is called amplitude shift keying. In ASK, the two binary waves are represented by two different amplitudes of carrier frequency. Commonly, one of the amplitude is zero, that is, one binary digit is represented by the presence of carrier wave with constant amplitude, and the other binary is represented by absence of carrier wave. So, ASK wave is represented by S function T, and it is equals to AC cos 2 pi FCT for symbol 1 and 0 for symbol 0. Which means that for symbol 1 there is a presence of carrier wave, and for symbol 0 there is an absence of carrier wave. And this is called amplitude shift keying. But in digital communication, the carrier amplitude is expressed in terms of bit energy EB and bit duration TB. And using formula of sinusoidal power, PS equals to 1 upon 2 AC square, we can write carrier amplitude AC equals to under root of 2 into PS. So the modified ASK wave is equals to under root of 2 into PS cos 2 pi FCT for symbol 1 and 0 for symbol 0. Also, sinusoidal power PS can be written as EB upon TB, that is bit energy per unit bit duration, and unit is joule per second or simply watt. So the ASK wave in terms of bit energy and bit duration is expressed as S function T equals to under root of 2 EB upon TB cos 2 pi FCT for symbol 1 and 0 for symbol 0, where EB is called transmitted signal energy per bit. Now, this ASK waveform can also be represented by a unit energy function, that is called single basis function. And it is defined by phi function t equals to st upon under root of bit energy. And the expression of single basis function is equals to under root of 2 upon TB, that is bit duration, into cos 2 pi FCT. And this is for time duration T greater or equals to 0 and less than or equals to TB. This single basis function having unit energy. Next, we discuss the time domain representation of amplitude shift keying or on-off keying. ASK in terms of single basis function is denoted by simply the product of under root of EB and phi t. Here under root of EB is amplitude of rectangular pulse which represents symbol 1 and phi t is unit energy single basis function. So the binary input data level 0 comma under root of EB and single basis function phi t is passed through the product modulator. And the output of product modulator is the ASK wave that is denoted by S function t equals to under root of 2 EB upon TB cos 2 pi FCT for symbol 1 and 0 for symbol 0. So we can say that in ASK the wave S function t is transmitted for symbol 1 and for symbol 0 there is no waveform that is shown in figure. Here the input binary symbol 0 and 1 is first encoded into two possible levels. For symbol 0, the level is 0 and for symbol 1, the encoded level is under root of EB. And this encoding technique is called unipolar NRZ, that is non-return to 0. And for symbol 1, there is a presence of carrier wave and for symbol 0, there is no carrier wave. And this technique is called amplitude shift keying. So, in the simplified form of ASK, S function t is equals to under root of EB into phi t for symbol 1 and 0 for symbol 0. Here, symbol 1 corresponds to the amplitude level under root of EB denoted by S1 and symbol 0 corresponds to the amplitude level 0 denoted by S2. These symbols S1 and S2 can be represented on spatial diagram. That is called signal space diagram or signal constellation for ASK. Here, both the symbols S1 and S2 are represented on the single basis function axis. Symbol S2, which corresponds to symbol 0, is at the origin, while the symbol S1 corresponding to symbol 1 having positive value of under root of EB. Also, on this signal constellation diagram, there is a decision boundary that is situated at the half of the distance between these two points and it is called threshold value. So, in ASK, the threshold value is under root of EB upon 2. And this decision boundary divides the entire space into two decision regions. Region Z1 belongs to symbol 1 and its range is from under root of EB by 2 to plus infinity. And region Z0 belongs to symbol 0 having range from minus infinity to under root of EB by 2. So, from the signal constellation diagram of ASK, we conclude that the threshold value is under root of EB by 2. And this threshold value is used at the decision making device at the receiver side for ASK demodulation purpose. Now, after discussing signal constellation diagram, we move to the power spectral density of ASK wave. And after this, with the help of power spectral density, we can determine the bandwidth of ASK wave. For this, we again consider a block diagram which includes a product modulator having two inputs. Here, input binary data, that is line encoded signal having two possible levels, 0 for symbol 0 and under root of EB for symbol 1. And this is called unipolar NRZ binary level data. And the power spectral density of unipolar non-return to 0 is denoted by SB function f. After modulation using a single basis function phi, we get ASK wave. And the power spectral density of ASK is denoted by S suffix S, which we are likely to be discussed. So, first we talk about power spectral density of unipolar NRZ binary data level, having two possible levels, 0 and under root of EB. As this data level is represented as rectangular pulse of amplitude under root of EB, its power spectral density in frequency domain is denoted by S suffix B, and it is equals to A square upon 4 del function F plus A square TB upon 4 sinc square F into TB. Here A is equals to under root of 2 EB upon TB, that is the product of under root of EB and under root of 2 upon TB, where under root of EB is simply the amplitude of rectangular pulse which represents symbol 1 and under root of 2 upon TB is carrier amplitude. And the first term of power spectral density denotes impulse function, that is at origin and having a value A square upon 4. And the second term represents the sinc function with 0 crossing at 1 upon TB, 2 upon TB, 3 upon TB, etc. In the power spectral density of binary input level, maximum amount of power is introduced by the main lobe, having main lobe width equals to 2 upon TB. Now after modulation using high frequency single basis function phi, this spectrum that is centered at origin gets shifted to plus minus fc, that is a carrier frequency, and produces an ASK wave. So the power spectral density of ASK wave is expressed by S suffix S equals to 1 upon 4 within bracket S suffix B f minus fc plus S suffix B f plus fc, which shows that the power spectral density of input binary level that is centered at origin gets shifted to plus minus fc and amplitude becomes 1/4, and this is called frequency translation. This power spectral density of ASK wave has a disadvantage of infinite bandwidth, but practically the bandwidth of ASK is defined by the bandwidth of an ideal bandpass filter that is centered at carrier frequency. So the power spectral density of ASK with infinite bandwidth get converted into band limited ASK wave using bandpass filter that is centered at carrier frequency. This band limited ASK is shown in figure. Here, only the main lobe is allowed to pass through bandpass filter and side lobes are removed. So, from the figure, upper frequency is fc plus 1 upon TB and lower frequency is fc minus 1 upon TB. And the bandwidth, that is the difference between upper frequency and lower frequency, is equals to 2 upon TB. That is called maximum bandwidth of ASK. Also, in terms of bit rate or signaling rate, the maximum bandwidth is equals to twice of bit rate. So we can say that the transmitted bandwidth of ASK depends upon the bit rate or signaling rate S, that is equals to 1 upon TB. And it is expected that transmission bandwidth is proportional to bit rate S. But practically, the transmission bandwidth of ASK is restricted or reduced because of using bandpass filter. And this restricted bandwidth is equals to 1 plus D into S, where D is a factor related to the filter characteristic and modulation process. Typically, the value of D lies between 0 and 1. So, when we take D equals to 0, we get minimum transmission bandwidth, that is equals to S, and when D equals to 1, we get maximum transmission bandwidth of 2 into bitrate. So, after discussed the signal constellation diagram and bandwidth of ASK, which is 1 plus D into S, we go through the basic concept of bitrate and baud rate. Bitrate S is simply the number of bits transmitted per second, and baud rate denoted by N suffix B is the number of symbols transmitted per second, or we can say that number of levels per second. Also, there is a relationship between bitrate and baud rate, and this relation is baud rate N suffix B equals to bitrate S upon M, where M is the number of bits per symbol. For example, when each symbol consists of 2 bit, then the baud rate is half of the bitrate. Also, when the symbol consists of 3 bits, then in this case the baud rate is S by 3. But when each symbol consists of only 1 bit, then the baud rate is equals to bit rate, and this is the case of amplitude shift keying. So in ASK, bit rate equals to baud rate, and the transmission bandwidth can also be written in terms of baud rate. That is, transmission bandwidth equals to 1 plus D into baud rate.